In this blog, we will try to see the implementation of permission handling in iOS-based Flutter application. So in our previous tutorial, we have seen permission handling in Android-based Flutter application. And in this part of the tutorial, we'll be mainly concentrating on how to get the permissions in iOS-based app. So now, the very first thing I would like to share here is this is a continuation of our previous tutorial, and the code for this particular tutorial I'm providing in the description section below. And also I suggest you to watch the previous tutorial before getting started with this particular tutorial, because I have made use of the same code, and also you can just get the detailed explanation of the code in our previous tutorial. So now let's get started with this particular tutorial. So the very first step is we need to add the dependency here in pubspec file here. So that is permission handler. And now come back to our code here, and under iOS directory here you will be having pod file. So now you need to specify the permissions which you require in the application. So here for sample tutorial purpose, I have specified few permissions over here, and I would like to show you one or two permissions here in this part of tutorial. So these are the permissions which we use almost in every application, like contacts, camera, microphone, calendar, and that too depending upon your requirement. So now I'm going to show you with a location permission, because it's important nowadays, like every application might have the location requirement in their app to serve the user based on their location. So now let's go back to our code here in main.dart file, and here I have specified permission as location now. So you are having a lot of options here, like camera, calendar, photos, all these things. But just for example purpose, I am showing you location here. And in our previous tutorial, how to fetch the location permission in Android device, I have explained. So in this part of the tutorial, same location permission in iOS device, I am going to explain now. So in the pod file, whenever you specify these particular permissions here, so the very first thing, so after adding all these permissions in the pod file, the very first thing you need to do is right click on the iOS folder and open in terminal. And now let's try to install pod here. So after adding all these permissions, you need to run this particular command pod install. So I have already done this particular step here. And whenever you're trying to implement this particular tutorial, make sure you perform this particular step, or else you will not get the proper output. And now go back to info.plist file. So inside the pods, so inside the runner folder here, you are having info.plist file. So info.plist and pod file are the important files whenever you are dealing with the iOS application with the help of Flutter. So now here we are going to add the location permission. So even in info.plist file, we need to specify the location permission details here, or else it will not work when you only specify in pod file. So make sure you specify the required things in both the pod file and info.plist file. And if at all you are having any queries, just let me know in the comment section below, or else you want to implement any other permission, just let me know in the comment section below. I will surely try to help you. So now we have added in the both the places, like pod file and info.plist file, and in the main.dart also we have specified permission.location here. And it's time to run our application and check whether this works or not. So I have opened my iOS phone simulator and try to run this particular code. And if you are a beginner, it might be very much difficult for you to seek permission in iOS application. But once you follow this particular tutorial, it will be very easy for you in handling the permissions both in Android and iOS device. And also the code for this tutorial I am providing in the description section below. Just try to go through it if you are having any queries in the implementation. So now our code is now up and running. And now let's try to tap on check permission button here. And here you can see we are able to see location permission on our device. So it is asking us to allow. And here Flutter Basics is our application name. And it is saying allow Flutter Basics to use your location. And again, it's your requirement. You can just tap on allow once or allow while using this app. So In this way, here you can see permission is granted. I have made use of a snack bar here in showing up like permission is granted. And if you have not allowed, then you will be going to the else block of code, and there you can go according to your requirement, as if you want to ask the user one more time, or you just go, or you just stop the user from using your application because the permission was not granted. So all these things you can execute in the else block of code. And now let us try to see one more permission handling just as for a tutorial purpose. So here we have like photo library. So I have added the photo library permission as well. So now let's go back here, and instead of location, now let's try to specify photos here, and now try to rerun this particular code. And here you can see the application is restarted. And when you tap on check permission here, this time you are seeing like Flutter Basics would like to access your photos. And once you tap on select photos here, you can open the gallery here. So here my gallery has been opened in my simulator, and you can select any one of the image and tap on. So in this way, we'll implement the permission handler in iOS devices as well. So I hope this is very clear for you to understand. And once again, I'd like to suggest you to go through these two tutorials on permission handler in Flutter application, and the code for this tutorial is provided in the description section below. If you are having any queries, just let me know in the comment section below. And this is it for this particular tutorial. If you like this tutorial, do like, share and subscribe to our channel for more interesting content on Flutter.